Hi, thanks for watching Simple Tools with Denise. I have an online video course for teaching R. It's called The Impossible R Made Possible. And in that course, I have a lot of ideas for helping kids learn to self-monitor. So listen to themselves and realize when they are or aren't saying R correctly. And those techniques I talk about have been working for me for a long, long time. But last month, I had a client and all those ideas, they just weren't getting her to where she was really self-monitoring. We were doing this poem, Invitation by Shel Silverstein. If you are a dreamer, come in. If you are a dreamer, a wisher, a liar, a hoper, a prayer, a magic bean buyer. Anyway, if I had her do one line, she'd get all the R's. If I had her do two lines, she could most of the time get all the R's. Beyond that, R's are just dropping out. If I recorded her and had her listen back to herself, she could pick out every R she said wrong. But she was just stuck there, moving forward. So then I got this idea, and this is not in my R course. This is a brand new idea, so here we go. It's one of my new favorite self-monitoring tools. I realized she needed to be aware in the moment, the exact moment, of whether she was saying R or not. And she had no problem saying it. I mean, she was past the point where there was any problem with saying it motorically. It was just remembering to say it. So I said, okay, I gave her a pencil, I gave her a pad of sticky notes. I said, every time you say R, I want you to make a tally mark. So I wanted her to do this. If you are a dreamer, come in. If you are a dreamer, a wisher, a liar, that was my idea. But this is what she did at first. She went, if you are a dreamer, come in. And then she would try and remember back what she had said. Well, that wasn't working. This is where the real breakdown was. Just getting her to mark a tally for each R in the moment she said it. It took her a couple trials to get to that, and then she started to do it. And guess what? She could do it. And so we did a couple of times the whole poem with her making a tally mark every time she said an R. And if she didn't make that tally mark in the moment she said it, I would stop her, because this is what was important. So, you know, if you are a dreamer, two R's in dreamer, sometimes that trips them up. If you are a dreamer, a wisher, a liar, a hoper, a prayer, a magic bean buyer, after a couple times through that, she was able to put the pencil down, not make the tally marks, and go through the whole poem and get every R right. And then now we're starting to move forward again in therapy, because now she can realize when she is saying R or not in the moment she's saying it. So I hope you have fun with this technique. Thanks for watching.